According to new statistics, the number of Americans having sex is at a record low, and we can thank, in part, technology. The Washington Post this week laid out new statistics that show not only are we not having sex, but the number of young men not having sex is at a 30-year high. With me now is Harlan Cohen, who is a relationship expert and the author of the book, Getting Naked, Five Steps to Finding the Love of Your Life. Harlan, good to be with us. This is one of those segments that's going to make a whole lot of people blush. So, what is behind these stats that show our younger generation, particularly young men who would usually be at their peak at about that age bracket, you know, not having sex?
Absolutely. And, you know, it's another Sunday after a sexless Saturday night for more.
What's going on?
18 to 34 year olds. Right. Yeah. So I'm the messenger here. I'm the expert on no sex. This is who they call the no sex expert here. And I can tell you, I look at this not as a sex issue. Okay. I look at this as an intimacy issue.
Yeah.
Now, I've been working with teens, 20 somethings for over 20 years, and never before have I seen them struggle when it comes to saying what they think, expressing how they feel during daylight hours while sober.
Okay? Wow.
Now this is the problem. When you say what you think and express how you feel, the people who you're communicating with may respond in many ways.
And might find you attractive or appealing.
They might say yes, and they might say, ugh.
Right.
They might not be interested.
And okay, when it comes to rejection, what's behind people not being, I mean, what's behind, it sounds like, people being so antisocial? What do you blame?
You know,
how is it they can't communicate with one another?
It is so hard to express themselves because when people don't respond, there is this adverse reaction to rejection. They're not trained when it comes to expressing themselves. And when they do, there's a good chance someone might get uncomfortable and they can't do it at work because of sexual harassment. So really, where do people learn how to communicate face to face to be able to engage in real relationships and experiment with intimacy? And they don't teach it in schools. Mm-hmm. There aren't classes on this. And what we've seen is more ways for people to numb out and disengage through Netflix, through cell phones, through apps. And then there's also ways where people can consume with record number of people consuming pornography. So there's this sense of false intimacy, this inability to communicate, and we see this all converging. And this is the space that I live in, helping 20-somethings, helping men to be able to get comfortable with the uncomfortable.
So the general social survey agrees with you and, you know, blames largely this addiction to social media, gaming, gadgets, I mean, all this technology that's standing in the way of people being able to zero in on one another, take the time, I guess, to, you know, develop a relationship. So what kind of advice are you going to give people now?
So I would say,
You're like, I'm
chomping. Right. It's easy to blame those things, but instead of blaming those things, if you're somebody who craves intimacy, asking yourself the question, why is it so hard for me to say what I think and express how I feel? How could I put myself in more rooms with more people having shared experiences over time? Because that's how you build meaningful relationships, is shared experiences over time. And if you look at more people living at home, if you look at more people working remote, if you look at more people being isolated, they are not in rooms, they're not in people, they're not communicating. So the answer is, put yourself in places where you can share what you think, express how you feel, do things so you feel amazing about yourself, so anyone who gets an invitation to your life is the luckiest person in the world, because they're
like
missing
that.
Out on you.
They're missing
You're there.
Out. What
right.
are they thinking? So then, wait a minute. So then, while you may come to the table with that, you're like, okay, I'm an open book. I want to, you know, engage with people and talk, You got to make sure that you're in a place where everybody else is of the same mindset, because then there you are, all alone, available.
Absolutely.
What
and this is one of the most important things, is you can communicate in a safe way. When you express interest, when you communicate, when you have a conversation with someone, you're telling them, I'm interested in getting to know you. And here's the big shift. Instead of trying to think, I want to be sexual or I want physical intimacy, ask yourself the question, are you as interesting as you are attractive when you see interesting people, and engage them from that level? And if you genuinely are interested and you're someone who believes you're interesting, then great things will happen. But this takes training, this takes practice, and it takes having people in your corner to help you. So if you do get rejected, and let me just make this point, rejection, our brain interprets it the same way we interpret physical pain.
Oh no, come on, Harlan. He was making some good points there. I know he had you on the edge of your seat, but you know what? We decided to mix things up a little bit. This is not what you expected today, but I bet you feel better for it. Harlan Cohen, wherever you are, thank you very much.
I guess you could call it Make America Date Again. Check out the new dating app for singles who are huge supporters of President Trump.
We're looking for Mr. Right.
We're looking for the right connection.
For these singles, the right connection means right wing and support for President Trump. So they've joined a new dating app called Writer. The app was created by professional matchmaker Christy Edwards.
What conservative in our country right now isn't a target? We are mocked. We are treated horribly.
For model Alyssa Brackley, it's a plan to make America date again.
I didn't think there was any conservative guys in California, so I'm really excited about the app.
Speech pathologist Elena Marujo says the new dating app is a relief after experiencing rejection for her political beliefs on other dating sites.
You get in a great conversation and maybe you're interested, and then all of a sudden the floor pulls out from under you because it's like, oh, no, never mind, sorry.
Now these conservative guys and gals are about to meet in person to see if sparks fly.
Excited. I mean, yeah, I'm like a huge romantic, so I'm always like, this is gonna be the guy.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Elena.
I'm Drew. Nice to meet you.
So far, so good. And how's this for an opening line?
Anybody watch the State of the Union?
Every minute.
Next, the group sits down for drinks.
Cheers.
So how did these singles do?
I wanted to ask you, would you like to go out for dinner?
Yeah, absolutely.
Looks like a step in the right direction.
A recent poll found that 71% of people using online dating apps consider political differences a deal breaker.